Last time when I played with my wife, half my mind was always with her.
You're sending your wife to Exile Island. What's the feeling right now?
I got nothing.
It's emotional, you know, with Val. I really love her, and I care about what she's doing. I wasn't focused.
Eighth person voted out, the second member of our jury.
So I was blindsided by my own alliance. I went home, took it hard. Now, I want the money for Val more than for me. Like, I just need to go through this again. I'm back for some redemption. We're gonna move on, and we're good. With the tribe, I feel good. I knew my season, that they saw me as a threat. So I figure, let me talk to Keith. The only thing I'm hoping that if Keith hears my name, that he comes back to me. In my head, Keith, we were good.
Me too.
I'm trying to go strategically and like really use my head this season. So I wanted Tasha, probably the strongest female out here.
As long as it's not me, I'm cool. Mm-hmm.
And I wanted Savage. Savage seems like a real straight up guy, another physical threat.
I'm telling you, I'm the guy. I got your back.
Yeah. We're good. What about Fish?
I don't have a good feeling about Fish.
But my number one that I wanted was Joe. There's no bigger shield out here than Joe.
We got an awesome group.
Definitely. Savage is on board.
Yeah?
I like it.
Cool.
And it kind of worked out that way. And I think it'll be so dumb for someone to mess this up.
I'm putting it to work.
And I feel like we have the stronger group. We could really move on in this game. We could make some noise. We just got to stick together and get each other's back.
Trying to have fun and be all business. And then Savage bringing up that story with his wife. Yeah, it touches you, you know? Makes you think.
My wife is pregnant, and I just want to see her stomach. You know what I mean? I want to be there to see it grow.
I'm not telling anybody.
I got so much riding on me anyways. I know they're gonna come after me as a physical threat. And you're gonna add on that my wife is pregnant. No one's gonna wanna take me to the end.
But I gotta control this a little bit. Val knows how much this means to me and to her, you know? She's the reason why I'm doing this again, you know?
I'm sure I'm thinking about it too much.
If you love her, you love her, you know what I mean? When Spencer joined up, he needed to talk to me. And it was good to sit down and talk because I think he's a stand-up guy, like someone that you could really connect with and trust. He's funny and like, I'm digging the kid. He's all right. Like I love Val, right? At going through Survivor last year with her, like it multiplied it by like 10. I think we could definitely have a bond. I'm not sure how long we'll keep him, but we could use him for right now. You know, I'll take that. I'm so frustrated looking for that thing. It's not here. You know what I mean? Is it underground? Is it in a tree? Is it high up? Is it in the water? Like, I don't know nothing. It could be anywhere, but this is my second chance, and I feel like I have to work harder this time.
There was a little tree full of leaves, and I started digging in it, and the thing just popped up like, whoop. I said, ah. I was so pumped.
Congratulations, you have found a clue to the hidden immunity idol. In the middle of your next immunity challenge, on the back of the third box is my hidden immunity idol.
Finally, 2 seasons it takes me, and I finally find some. But is it an idol? No, it's not an idol. It's a clue to an idol that I have to grab when 18 people are playing around me. I'm gonna make it work. We're gonna get this thing. I'm gonna bring this thing home. Oof.
In that last immunity challenge, I found the hidden immunity idol, but I couldn't even celebrate. Like, I got it, and I'm like, oh, I'm so happy. Finally, it took 2 years to get this thing, but I finally got my idol. That's a thing of beauty. That's a thing of beauty. I love it.
This is my idol. I'm not telling anybody. So I told Steven that we gotta really look for this thing because I don't need him to think that I have it.
What we can do is we could start here. You go that way.
Yep.
I'll go that way. And we'll just hit it hard.
Yep.
We gotta find this thing.
It's out here.
I want Steven to think that I'm still looking for it and it's for us. I wanna keep pulling him close. I know they're gonna come after me at some point. And I want him to be the one to say, listen, they're coming after you. And then I got my get out of jail free card. I would love to be Steven's JT. We could be friends for life after this.
I'll give you second place if you're happy with that. I'm not happy with second place. Juice, I got nothing for you.
I give more attention to the chicken, to Juicy J, than anybody else does. And I feel bad for her, because we don't have food, so she's not eating. There's no meat on her anyways. What are we gonna do with her? Juicy J is getting out. I'm all about eating the chicken. You know what I mean? Like, name a brother that doesn't eat a chicken, you know? But don't starve it to death in the cage. That's horrible. So if they catch her, they're gonna wanna cook her. I want no parts of that. I'm not killing her. I'm not plucking her. I'm not cooking her. But I'll eat her. I want them to go at it, and I want to sit back and just watch it and just laugh. This season is all about having fun, and that's my comic hour.
Here.
That chicken's done. He's gone. He sees freedom, and she's gone. There's four original Bayonne, and then it's Wiggles and Spencer that are on the outs.
Hey, win some, lose some. Yeah. Oh, good. Sorry, I didn't get more.
So all I'm thinking is, who do I trust more going into this game? Like, do I trust Spencer to go with me, or could I trust Wigglesworth?
Blindside Monica.
Monica's just, I don't know what Monica's doing. Like, why would you go and tell Kimmy we need to keep the girls' numbers? Like, why would you do that? So it would be cool to see Monica go home off of that.
I don't trust Joel. So, like, I would be happy to lose him. Like, immediately.
But I want to do Joe first.
Steve is definitely digging his heels and he wants Joe out. But I need a shield. I need Joe around as long as possible. I do not want to be the biggest guy out here.
Do we need to split it, or are we just...
I don't think we do.
Not.
Does Cass have an item?
I don't think she does.
It looks like everybody is voting Cass, but Cass could have an idol. You know what I mean? Like, it's always good to split votes.
So I was thinking, if Joe loses, it could be a chance to... We got Joe.
Since day one, Steven has been trying to get Joe out. And I was reluctant because I'd lose out on Joe as a shield. But every time Joe wins, it just keeps getting that bullseye bigger and bigger on his back. So the first time Joe loses, he could be going home.
Let's push it back.
That's the plan now?
Yeah. Steven's bringing up Joe's name. It's a huge threat.
Savage. Now he wants to take out Steven because he's been trying to get rid of Joe. But I just feel like that would be a bad move for me because Steven's been with me for 20 days. And I've been building trust with him. So I want Steven to come with me far into this game. Because once the big guys start going at each other, I want to have all the bullets. Savage going home screws me. I had another man that nobody really likes that I knew that was a shield for me. But even though I trust Steven and I have one idol to protect me, I need two idols because they're coming after me. I gotta look, I gotta bust my behind again. Like, oh my God. We weren't even close, it was embarrassing. Like, this whole day is a waste of a day for me. This is a bad one. Last night was bad, Savage went home. Today's bad, it goes up and down, today's the down.
I'm pissed off that we lost. And not that we just lost, because we lost by so much, we just got crushed. But with only five other people, they're cooking and talking and everything, they're gonna let me go and leave me alone. And I went and looked for the idol. I wanted to check tree mail, and I'm digging around tree mail and everything, and nothing around there. The first idol I got was in a tree under leaves. So I was like, there's a huge tree at tree mail.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
When I turned around, like, it was just staring at me.
Congratulations, you have found a clue that will lead you to a hidden immunity idol. But it will require you, oh my God. But it will require you to be sly and inconspicuous.
Tonight, after everyone else lies down to go to sleep, you will make your move, follow the map, and look for the lantern. There you will find the security you seek. So it's kind of like the same trail that we did for the merge. Soon as the moon goes down, the team that won came back from their spa treatment. And everybody usually in the bed, ready for bed. So I was like, this is gonna be so easy. I'll just get up. They're not gonna be watching me.
You know, you come on down, you know, go see.
But I'm like, this is ridiculous. Everybody's by the fire, hanging out. Like, no one ever, they never ever do this. So it was crazy.
Now don't stay up, y'all youngsters, don't stay up all night now.
Finally, I'm just like, I gotta go to the bathroom. That food messed up my stomach.
Then I just made a dash for it. You know, I just took off. It's pitch black. There's rocks, there's trees, there's, like, I don't even know what's out there. There's snakes and everything, and I'm just, like, smacking branches out of my face.
I see a horse.
From a distance, I see a little glow. So I kind of took off after it.
Ooh, buddy. Look at that thing.
This is what I'm talking about. Idols this season, there's no two idols that look the same. And hanging from the lantern was this beautiful thing.
We got number two. It took me 2 years, but now I got two idols. Two hidden idols.
With two idols, I can be like a little bit more aggressive.
That's the blues. This is an idol.
This is Val's idol. This one is Val's idol. The other one's Val's idol.
This is a beautiful thing. I love it.
Val's my wife. Like, Val's my best friend, you know? I can't keep it balled up anymore. Like, and I'm doing it all for her. I just want to make her life a little easier. I want to make Jay and Cam's life a little easier. And I want to make my next child's life a little easier. Like, I don't even know if it's a boy or a girl. And, like, that's been bothering me a little bit. Like, I know people are after me, and I gotta figure out when I could use these idols, because I gotta use them at the right time. I just want Val to win, you know? I just want Val to win. Like, she deserves it more than me, you know? Man.
You sure they're down? They're, like, gonna make a...
We're all set with taking out one of the three witches.
So, like, I'm really hesitant with Steven, because...
Steven's running around, because everyone's trying to play their own game, and I just want... everyone to be on the same page. But like, the person that I still trust the most is Steven.
You're asking me to trust three girls that want nothing to do with me.
I'm not asking you to trust the girls. I'm asking you to trust their momentary, like, it's like this is a game of voting blocks, right? It's not a game of long-term alliances.
I'm just trying to lock down my alliance and trying to work these other voting blocks.
Look at where, like rain again.
Yep, sure does.
My problem is, if we take Wigglesworth away, there'll be four people that'll come back to camp blindsided. Kimmy, Tasha, Keith, Joe. You know, I don't want to have to worry. But I want to make the right decision and the right move. I don't want to just jump ship and do it so fast.
So at Tribal tonight, Steven, Spencer, and myself blindsided Kelly Wigglesworth. I still think that we could jump back to our power group or whatever we want to call it and take out another one of the girls. Maybe Sierra can go.
Every vote is like a new game. If I can't clean up, then they're gonna come after me next.
So I knew I was gonna have to come right back and talk to Tasha. I knew she was gonna be upset.
Steven does not look good. I feel bad for him. His stomach's messed up and his feet are swollen. He looks so bad. He looks so bad. I'm hoping he's okay, because I need some loyalty around me. And Steven is an honest guy.
What's up with your foot? Why are you limping around?
It's a mess.
I love Survivor, but it's a tough game. Every day it's tough. We're freezing, the wind is cold, and the shelter is horrible. It doesn't hold up against the elements out here.
You can't ever get warm, so we're just huddled up together. It sucks.
We need something, you know? If we can get warm and get everything dry for one day, we'll be all right.
He's not pulling anything out. As long as it's a blindside, we all vote Steven.
It's a bad move.
Some people saying maybe they want to vote Steven out because of his advantage. I don't feel like that's a great idea right now. I have two idols, but I need Steven. Steven at least has my back. I want Steven to stay. Steven, trust me.
I owe you my life in this game.
Told you, and man. Like, that means
when
something.
You have my back, I got your back. You know what I mean?
So, well,
I know that Steven will have my back, and I think Steven wants to take me all the way to the end, and I like that. I need that.
That was awesome. That was cool, right?
When you make moves like that, a big move like that, I know there's going to be a huge target on me now after doing it, but this game is so crazy, I feel like everybody's still in it. So I have wiggle room to make the next move.
Yeah, inside they're so disgusting. The indignities continue.
Steven's feet look so bad. They're swollen. They look like a lobster claw. You know, they're so nasty. Like, I'm looking at her face and I'm like, you do not get paid enough for this.
You know what? Let's not do it, actually. Sorry, it hurts. Yeah, thank you.
Steven put her out of her misery. She did not want to do that. So bad.
I just want to make sure we're still good.
No, like, we're still good. Like, I still trust you.
I didn't want Steven gone. Now, I feel like I'm in trouble. I don't feel comfortable with anything.
We should just, like, figure out where things stand. It's going to be like it has been. It's going to be, like, picking up the pieces.
Yeah,
you know?
That's true.
These voting blocks just keep moving, and I don't like that feeling. I like to be in the middle of everything and know what's going on.
It's a boy.
I knew it. So Val said, it's a boy. I'm gonna have a son. That's wild. But I don't want anybody to know right now. They don't need to know.
It will not be all girls. I've been locked in since day one, and that's it.
I was planning on voting out Joe, and then Tasha tells me this talk about an all-girls alliance.
Oh my God.
We need Tasha.
You gotta lock her in then.
If those girls take over the game, me and Spencer, we're all done. Our games are over. So having Tasha on my side is crucial right now.
The problem is, I don't think you trust that we're not gonna do the all-girl alliance. Like, I think that's in the back of your mind. So let's just talk about that.
Yeah, it's not true at all. So I trust you guys.
If the girls are all saying, like, let's get out Keith, you know, that's an option. But I have buyer's remorse right now because we should have kept Joe and got rid of Abby. I'm not even mad about going on that reward today. Like, listen, I'm gonna eat on day 39. Give me that breakfast. And, like, let me tell everybody on the jury why I deserve that $1 million. That's all I want.
I can handle this. You guys go have your talk. No, I don't want to be rushed. We'll just wait till
it's... Let's chill. It's not a big deal.
Is Abby a Scorpio? Scorpios are crazy. I got two of them in my house. That's why I drink.
If we screw this one vote up, we're done.
Tasha said, what do you think about if we vote Abby out? It does give me one less girl that I don't have to worry about. So, yeah, I like that idea.
Now you think Spencer's for sure locked in?
I think Spencer's locked in.
We'll see what Spencer says.
Tasha is kind of iffy on Spencer. She doesn't know if he's going to be 100%.
It is a possibility that he could jump ship
and just run and tell Kelly and Keith the whole plan, and it will blow up in our face. We're still worried about an idol out there, so let's just split the vote to take out Kelly or Keith. We're all safe, and we're still going in tomorrow with numbers.
She's lying, man.
My voting block is skeptical on Kimmy. I don't think Kimmy's trying to do anything. I feel like my alliance is strong. The problem, though, is that with the hidden immunity idols, it shakes up everything, and we don't want to lose this. We have numbers. We could really run this to the end. I know Kimmy's kind of goofy and everything, but I really think she's with us. And I don't want to use my idol and not have it tomorrow. So, I mean, the safer move would be to split the vote. Guys vote for Wentworth. Girls vote for Keith.
If one of them has an idol, like, what can we do?
I think there is a huge possibility that Keith or Kelly are gonna pull out a hidden immunity item tonight. I'm so worried about that.
They ain't say nothing to you?
Nope.
Yeah. It's either me or Spencer that they're gonna put votes on. I'm worried, point blank. If Keith has an idol, one of us are going home. It's probably gonna be me. I think they're gonna go after me. And I don't even want to take a chance on it.
Oh, this is for Val. This is for Jordan. This is for Cameron. This is for my son that's not even here yet. Like, this is for them all. Now, the question is who I'm going to the end with. Because I don't want second. I don't want third. Like, I need to win this.
That was good.
I feel like I want to laugh. I want to cry. I want to yell. You know what I mean? Like, just want to explode. Because I feel like the season's so hard. And just to have this security just for tonight, it's just a beautiful thing.
Well, I forget how emotional I am, y'all.
No. Hey.
It was earned. It was deserved. Yeah.
I have my alliance. I have Spence and I have Tasha. But when you have this necklace, all bets are off. You know, you're like, I know we said we were going to do this, but now is the time when you figure out who's the best person that I could sit next to that I could win $1 million.
I don't know what to do yet.
Spencer and Wentworth both have pretty good resumes. The question is, who gives me the best chance to win?
I know he feels confident he can win. He told me that. Mm. But
would you do fire?
Would I do fire?
Yeah.
Want to tie?
Yeah.
Of course I would.
I'm trying not to let the necklace go to my head, you know? But what if we made Spencer and Wentworth go against each other in a tie and make fire?
All right, well, I'm thinking. I'm not,
I know you
don't,
are.
Think,
I know.
Don't think that it's done, you know?
Like, no, I know.
Spence came from the bottom, won a couple immunities. He's a smart player. Kelly's won 2 immunities. She's played 2 hidden immunity idols. She's an underdog. It all comes down to tonight. I'm gonna make my decision at trial, whether it's gonna be Spencer or Kelly. If I want to stick with my alliance, I could stick with them. If not, I could jump ship.
This is a $1 million decision.
It's huge.
This is what Final 3 feels like.
Yeah.
It's nerve-wracking, man. My second chance is all about Val and the kids.
I just want them to be proud of me, and I just want to take care of them. I miss them so much, I didn't leave this long for nothing. Oh man, can't lose this. This is right there, it's so close.
I have a 1 in 3 shot at $1 million. So I want to show the jury that I was in control of this game. I've had 2 hidden immunity idols, 1 immunity win.
I surrounded myself with the right people at the right time, and even up to the end, I feel really good.
I gotta finish this game, get that money, and bring home 4 of my family.